Yes, sister.
Good evening, sir. My name is Manju Singh. I would like to ask you one question. First of all, that I would like to tell you something. And I have seen your videos, that is Hinduism similarities with Islam. So I would like to ask you that, what is the difference if any non-Muslim will read with understand of Vedas, or he or she should read with understand of Al-Quran? So it is necessary that all the non-Muslims should go with through that Al-Quran.
Sister asked a very good question, that what is the importance of reading the Veda with understanding? Like how I gave a talk on Al-Quran, should it be with understanding? And the sister has seen my video cassette, the DVD, on similarities between Islam and Hinduism. And sister, towards the end of my talk, I told and I requested the government of India. I said that you should teach Sanskrit as a language. Unfortunately, Sanskrit has become a dead language. Only a handful of people know. I requested the government of India that teach Sanskrit so that the Hindus read the Veda. And when they read the Veda, they will come closer to Almighty God. When you read the Hindu scriptures, the Hindu scripture says, if you read the Upanishad, it's mentioned in Chandogya Upanishad, chapter number 6, section number 2, verse number 1, Ikkam Evidityam, God is only one without a second. It's mentioned in Sweta Sita Upanishad, chapter number 6, verse number 9, Nachasya Kasij Janita Nachadipa, of that God, He has got no superior, He has got no parents. Almighty God has got no father, He has got no mother. It's mentioned in Sweta Sita Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19, Natasya Pratimasti, of that God, there is no Pratima. Pratima in Sanskrit means image, photograph, picture, painting, sculpture, idol. According to Sweta Sita Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19, it says, Natasya Pratima Asti, of that God, there is no image, there is no picture, there is no painting, there is no portrait, there is no sculpture, there is no statue, there is no idol. Same thing, Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3, Natasya Pratima Asti, of that God, there is no image. So I'm asking you, sister, that if you read your Hindu scripture with understanding, not only chanting the verses, inshallah, you will come closer to God. And inshallah, you will submit your will to God. And if you read your Hindu scriptures, it's mentioned in the Hindu scriptures. I can give hundreds of references. It talks about the coming of the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If you read the Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 3, Adhyay 3, Shlokas 5 to 8, it speaks about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's mentioned in Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 3, Adhyay 3, Shlokas 10 to 27, about the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's mentioned in Atharva Ved, in Kuntab Sukta, in book number 20, hymn number 127, verse number 1 to 14. He's prophesied in Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 21, verse number 6. And only references I can keep on giving in which is mentioned about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's mentioned as Ahmad. Ahmad means one who praises. And he's mentioned several places. If you read Uttarchik, mantra number 1500, it speaks about Ahmad, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you read Indra, chapter number 2, verse number 152, it speaks about Ahmad. If you read Yajurved, chapter number 31, verse number 19, it speaks about Ahmad. He is also prophesied as Narashansa. Nar means man, Shansa means praiseworthy. Narashansa means a person who is praiseworthy. If you translate in Arabic, it is Muhammad. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned by name as Narashansa in several places. In Rigved, book number 1, hymn number 13, verse number 3. In Rigved, book number 1, hymn number 18, verse number 9. In Rigved, book number 2, hymn number 3, verse number 2. In Rigved, book number 7, hymn number 2, verse number 2. In Yajurved, chapter number 20, verse number 37. Yajurved, chapter number 20, verse number 57. Yajurved, chapter number 21, verse number 31. Yajurved, chapter number 28, verse number 19. I can go on quoting only references from the Hindu scriptures about the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So sister, if you understand Sanskrit, and if you read the Sanskrit scriptures, if you read scripture, you will understand that you should submit your will only to God. He has got no image. He has got no portrait. And you have to follow the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Thank you.